My name is Octavio Franco.
If you live near a marina,
you might see a boat, such as this one, discharging. You might be wondering what that is and why is that important. The lowest compartment of the boat is called the bilge. In the bilge, water can accumulate due to rain and condensation. When that happens, the bilge pump turns on to be able to discharge the water that's accumulated in the bilge. This is important because if water accumulates too high, it puts the boat at risk for sinking.
I'm Mary Lusk, and I'm an assistant professor in the Soil, Water, and Ecosystem Sciences Department at the University of Florida. My research focuses broadly on nutrients in wastewater and stormwater and their effects on the environment. Bilge water is very clean, and as long as the boater is practicing good practices, such as having adsorbers in their bilge water to collect any spilled oil, then that bilge water is going to be very clean. If that bilge water is polluted with a little bit of oil, then that becomes a concern for marine and coastal wildlife. That oil can get on like the feathers of birds and sea otters, for example. A lot of the same effect that birds have, that oil decreases their water repellency, and which means that the animal loses body heat, and sometimes they can die just from that, just from hypothermia. One of the biggest impacts of oil on marine organisms is its impact on fish. So the oil attaches to their scales and their gills, and it can make it hard for them to breathe because they need those gills to get oxygen. And when those gills are impaired by oil in the water, then the fish die because they're not able to breathe.
The bilge system is completely separate from the sewage system. Boats with installed toilets flush directly into a holding tank. Holding tanks is where black water is accumulated and then pumped out into a pump out system such as this one, where waste is sent to waste sewage treatment systems for proper disposal. Untreated waste can be discharged legally overboard when outside state waters, 9 nautical miles on the Gulf side and 3 nautical miles on the Atlantic side.
Boat sewage contains human waste, and it's similar to household sewage in that way, but it's different in the fact that boat sewage is more concentrated. So think about your home when you're flushing your toilets. You're also doing things like having bath water and sink water and laundry water. All of those things contribute lots of water to the household wastewater stream, and those water sources are not being added to boat sewage. So it's going to have nutrients, nitrogen and phosphorus that contribute to water quality impairments such as algal blooms and low oxygen zones in our marine ecosystems. So all of those things can be problems associated with that boat sewage.
Some boats have U.S. Coast Guard approved Type 1 or Type 2 marine sanitation devices that treat sewage to specific standards. These systems allow for boaters to legally discharge treated waste overboard as long as they're not in federally designated no discharge zones, inland lakes, reservoirs, or rivers that don't support interstate vessel traffic.
Boat treated waste will certainly have a reduced pathogen and solids load or solids component compared to untreated sewage waste, but it's still gonna have some nutrients, nitrogen and phosphorus that we need to be concerned about.
Thank you for watching this video, and I hope you learned something. If you want more information, please visit Florida Sea Grant website.